Hello and welcome to another video of JCL. In this video, I will explain all the basic things of JCL dataset attributes and their formats. And also, I will let you know how can you create PS and PDS file using ISPF menu. So let's go on the mainframe screen. This is ZOC terminal and Hercules mainframe. I use ZOS, but that is for my client work. I can't make tutorial on that operating system, so I am using this for making tutorial. Choosing here option 1, here we are going to allocate a data set. So here choosing option 3, utility, and for new create or catalog uncatalog data set, we should have choose option 2. And here giving command A, that means allocate new data set. And here I also, you can give here library as well as your user and second data set name and third as well as what type of, but I am giving here like a first one, that is Hercules 01, and then a study stool, and giving here enter. Here it is asking for record format. This field specifies the format of records in the dataset. Commonly we use fixed, variable and undefined. I explain you with diagram, then you will understand easily. This is the record format, F fixed, FB fixed block, U undefined. Mainly we use 3, but I am here mention 3 other as well, like V variable, VB variable grouped with block, VBS variable grouped with block, which can be extended. When we will allocate PS or PDS file, we will use F or FB. When we will work with COBOL or DB2, then we will see this undefined. So here I am giving FB, that's been fixed block, and then logical record length. This field specifies the length of the record in the dataset, and the length is measured in the bytes. You should remember that as well. And the block size could be a multiple of the record length. So I am giving 800. And the volume, this is the volume on which you want to allocate the data set. If you don't specify a volume, the system will allocate the data set on the default volume. In case if your admin provide you volume and unit, then you can fill that. I am leaving here empty as well. And here the allocation space unit, track or cylinder, or if this one is byte, I'll let you know. So first one is the track. A track is physical unit of storage on a disk or tape. It consists of a concentric ring of data that can be read or written to in the single revelation of the disk or tape drive. Second one is the cylinder. It is group of track that can be located on the same vertical axis of a disk or tape. And third one is the byte. It is a unit of digital information that consists of 8 bits. Giving here track and the primary space, I am giving here 5. This space allocation specifies the initial amount of space that is allocated for the data set when it is the first time created. And second one is the secondary space quantity. I am giving here 5 as well. This second space allocation specifies the amount of space that will be allocated when the data set grows beyond its primary space allocation. Primary space, that means the first space that will occupy it when we created this file. And the number of directory block, it is default 0. That's mean if this is the PS file, and if I give here 1, 2, or 3 directory block, then it could be PDS file. So I am creating PS file. So this is the right, giving here enter. So data set is allocated. So giving here back and going to 4 option to see the data set. So now we created Hercules study.stool. You can see inside the data, it is the empty data set because we haven't tried anything inside this. And as well, we can create PDS file also. So now giving here like Hercules 01, and the library I'm giving a study, and giving here type PDS. So we don't need to give here, and also we don't need to enter any colon or quotes here. Enter fix block, it is automatically defined. And now we are going to create PDS file, so here giving directory block 3D and enter. So now going to see F3 and 4 dataset and Hercules prefix and giving PDS we created this one, study.pds. So this is the end of this video. If you like the video, please do like and subscribe, and also you can press the bell icon to stay up to date with my latest videos. Thank you.